Welcome back, friends. In this video, we are going to talk about some information about the Spring Security. Let's say I have configured Spring Security in my application. Once you configure the Spring Security, it will ask each and every time username and password. Without entering username and password, we cannot access any endpoint, right? That is a default behavior of Spring Boot application. Okay. But I don't want to do that. Whenever I develop application, I don't want to enter username and password. It's irritating me. Okay, I want to disable that feature. Even Spring Security is configured. Okay, how to do that? I'll going to show the demo in this video. Okay, this is start.spring.io, com.io, I make it as IT Garden, then artifact IT Garden, package com.itgarden, then selecting 8, then dependencies as usual web and security. When you add Spring Security, automatically Spring Boot application enable the Spring Security in your application. By default, it enables the Spring Security in your application. It will create a one credential for you. By default, it will create a credential for you. The credential name is user, and it will create a random password. Okay, we have to enter that username and random password, then only you can access any endpoint, otherwise you cannot. Let's see that now. IT Garden, go to this location, extract this. Now I want to open that project. This IT Garden. Open a new window. See here. Dependency Spring Boot Starter Security, dependency Spring Boot Starter Web. This artifact automatically configure the Spring Boot. By default configuration is going to happen in this application because of auto configuration feature. Okay, now I'm going to start the application. Run as IT Garden application. Let's start running. Please look at the log here. Since I added this security artifact, one password is generated here. Randomly, it will get password generated. Whenever you stop the server, this password get destroyed. Whenever you start the server, new password get generated. This is the password to enter into your Spring Boot application. Okay, as of now, I don't have any endpoint, right? Let me create one endpoint. Okay, I'm going to create test controller. Add test controller, then public string get, simple method, make it simple. Return this is Spring Boot app. Then I want to make this method as a get mapping. Okay, now controller is ready. I want to access this controller. What is the endpoint to access this controller? http://localhost/8080, because my server is running in 8080, right? See here, it's running under 8080. If you access this endpoint, this method get called, because I'm not giving any path here. This method accessible through this URL. Okay. Let me restart the application now. Yeah, restart the application. This time it generates a different password. Okay. What is the default username? User. User is a default username. Using user, using this password only, you can access this particular endpoint now. Let me try to access this. See, it asking, please sign in. What you have to do? You enter user, then copy this password. sign in. See, this is Spring Boot app. So whenever you add this artifact, by default Spring Boot enabling the Spring security in your application at create one user called user and a password called password. This password generated each and every time when you start the application. So without this credential, you cannot access any endpoint. When I try to access this endpoint, it asking the username and the password, right? Once I enter the username and the password, I'm able to access this endpoint. Now I want to exclude that process. I want to exclude while developing my application. I don't want to enter username and the password each and every time. Okay. I want to exclude that. How to do that? It's a very simple. Go to your Spring configuration file. Here IT Garden is a my configuration file where you have to add one more parameter, exclude security auto configuration dot class. If you once you added this, your Spring security by default disabled. By default disabled in your application. It never asks each and every time when you access, when you try to access some endpoints. Okay, let's see that now. Application started. See, now it's not generating any password. When you see the console here, it's not generating any password. Now I can access this endpoint directly. It's already there. I'm closing this. Again, open new browser. Try to access. See, without that login screen, I'm able to access this particular endpoint. So through this way, you can disable the Spring security in your Spring Boot application, even you configure the Spring security. I hope you enjoyed this video. Until then, bye bye from Suresh. Still not subscribe this channel? Please subscribe it. Share this video to your friend circle. Click bell icon for regular updates. Thanks for watching this full video. Until then, bye bye from Suresh.